Welcome to 20 more Floorgasms, and enjoy. If you like your belts followed by death growls, then Floor's definitely got you covered on this one. I love the band interaction on this one, especially between Floor and Thomas. And the whole band just seems to be happy to be there. I like the little microtones in her delivery, and she's also really selling it at the end of this clip. Rising and falling vibrato are sick in this one. Kind of fun to see Floor in a more traditional mainstream kind of rock video, but she pulls it off. Has a dog tattooed behind one ear. She has a wolf tattooed behind the other. She says it describes her personality. Sometimes she feels like a dog, sometimes she feels like a wolf. I really love her cry and her use of vocal fry in this one. Short but great. Like a fire! She's the ghost baby. Take the ride. Moore's amazing delivery of the song makes her look like a doomed heroine from some Wagner opera. The floor's like, Thomas, you want me to hold that note for how long? The expression on her face and the passion and the way that she delivers this is just amazing. World-class windmilling and world-class singing? All right, try this one. Love the playfulness of the band on this one. Also, at the beginning, Floor conjures up her inner Alanis Morissette. This might be the grandest entrance by any performer I've ever seen. It's so amazing and classy, plus she just, her haunting voice is just amazing. What an amazing intimate space. Could you imagine listening to Floor at that kind of distance? I hope they have insurance though. I think she's going to blow the roof off the place. I miss Marco as much as anybody, but in this situation, Floor said, nope, I'll just do the damn thing. This was the opener for the Wacken 2013 concert, and a lot of people hadn't heard Floor before, and they were wondering if she was going to do a good job taking over the band. Well, she came out and kicked ass. Okay, so we have Floor Jansen in black latex singing Iron Maiden, and there's a guitar on stage. I am sold. Again, we have a small intimate setting, the small radio studio, and Floor belts it out like she's singing in front of 80,000 people. It's just so beautiful. My paragon. Oh, my dream is now my paragon. This recording was probably the gateway drug for most people. Got them interested in Floor and Nightwish. It's got thousands of reactions, and I know why. Okay, this one is kind of personal. This was my first exposure to Fleur. I had watched these voice coaches like The Charismatic Voice and Beth Wars that were covering like old metal bands and talking about the techniques that made them sound a certain way or the way they would choose to make these decisions with their voice. And I thought it was kind of cool. And one day up in the corner, there was a related video when it was Nightwish Ghost Love Score. And I clicked it and I watched part of this video. And as soon as she came out and started singing, I said, God, that's pretty. That is just pretty. And then when she hit that soaring note of My Fall, oh my God, I was just taken and obsessed from that very moment. That's the moment that Fleur got me, was when she said or sang My Fall for the first time with that soaring voice. I've been hooked ever since, and that's why I make these videos. Thanks for indulging me.
Beat.
This was the biggest mistake that I made on my top 25 Fleurgasms. Can't believe I didn't include this amazing track, and a lot of you people let me know it, so to everybody, it's number one on this list, so enjoy. Thank you for watching my video. Please like, subscribe, leave a comment. Also check out my other Fleur videos in the description, including the original top 25 Fleurgasms. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.